I'm not sure about what is happening now, but I think it was a great historical moment in the contemporary history of Egypt. And again, it was because of the interrelation between people and places, which is the thing that I'm really excited about. And I'm not excited about it as only to observe it, but also the whole concept of learning, how to learn from looking at people and places. And I will relate this to the contemporary narrative, the contemporary tale of the war. Can you use your question? Thank you. So it seems to me that the whole concept of learning is absolutely legitimate for any city. But the condition here is that in the process of learning, you don't imitate. You see the qualities. You look at qualities as opposed to you look at image. So I think I want to use one of the very interesting examples that I think it's definitely a good evidence of the meaning of learning from other places. And I'm talking here about the Pompidou Center, the very famous cultural center in Paris. I'm not that much into the beautiful architecture and the design and the whole story of the building that literally changed the architecture, the modern architecture movement. But I'm more excited about how to learn from the open space in front of the cultural center and how people sort of claim space within the city and create a wonderful relation between people and the cultural center. So learning from cities is important. And in this sense, it seems to me that it's not necessary to say Doha is not Paris or Doha is not Dubai. I am more excited about Doha is Doha. How Doha is going to create its own story. How Doha is going to create its own narrative. Learning from leaders also is very, very important. And I'm not doing this on a rhetoric, flattering kind of approach, but I'm talking about a sort of a historical moment in the contemporary history of Qatar, which has qualitatively changed the approach, the conceptual agenda for the progress and development of the country. Here you see a very interesting statement by Sheikha Moza, where she's saying it's about time to move from the typical status of the Middle East and the Arab as consumers of knowledge to producers of knowledge. So a different kind of identity to the Gulf, to the Middle East, and also to Qatar. Learning also from leaders, Sheikh Tamim in his speech at the United Nations. And for the very first time in the narrative of Gulf cities, you're talking about people. But when he elaborated on his perception of people, he meant both locals and expats. So a different again perception and approach to what do we mean by people engaged in the city or living in the city. And we need also to learn from intellectuals and scholars. And I would stop here in front of the work of Jane Jacobs and her beautiful, beautiful book, Death and Life of Great American Cities. She is describing cities almost 60 years ago, saying that the good city is the one that will provide something for everybody, and also everybody has a share in the creation of the city. So two beautiful conditions. And we have a lot of oil in the Gulf. Incredible financial resources. But quickly we fall into the trap of regional competition to build bigger and higher, and we had this even in the most sacred parts of the Gulf. This is my book, it's in Arabic, but it's criticizing the urban movement around the urban development around the Mecca, around Kaaba, and how we also resort to the concept of towers and sort of hurt the spirituality of the place. And then we realize that we are approaching a different paradigm, the post-carbon paradigm. It's really coming, not only because of the depletion of oil, but also the incredible decrease in prices and the environmental movements, and also new excellent resources, environmentally correct resources coming and feeding us. A lot of books are coming now in the direction of knowledge-based urban development, and I did participate in most of these books, but the final book, Knowledge-Based Urban Development in the Middle East, this is my book, and it will be in the market in the coming months. And half of the book is about Qatar and the experience of Qatar and how Qatar is moving towards this new paradigm in terms of urban development and city growth. Now let me put you in a sort of a scale here, because also we need to understand that the narrative of Qatar is relatively short if we compare it to Paris, for instance. This is Doha in 1937, Doha in the red frame. And if you trace this frame, you will see Doha now, and you can see the relation between the pace of development within 6 or 7 decades. Outstanding, outstanding. But this is the kind of development that would need us to pose and ask questions to see if we are on the right track or not. And therefore, we started to have a sort of principles and values that would guide us in according to the learning experience that we had. Values and principles related to engaging people, celebrating cultural diversity, inclusive public spaces, vibrant streets, promote the culture of walking, how to appreciate the environment, and how also to inspire and educate people via architecture and urbanism. Cultural diversity should be seen as an asset rather than creating barriers between people. So how this is also, how the city spaces and places are sort of demonstrating this and suggesting this. The first level to achieve this is what we call it the planning level. So for the very first time in the history of Qatar, we have now a Qatar National Master Plan, which is covering the whole of Qatar, the main 8 municipalities. And each of those municipalities now, they have a vision, they have a strategy, they have some goals related to their potentials, related to their challenges, and it's created all the way up to the zoning level and land uses level. And then particularly when it comes to Doha, we did introduce the concept also of urban centers to decentralize, as very typical in the Gulf, but we are moving more towards compacted level of urbanism. So you have different centers, urban centers with all the required facilities, distributed in a very balanced way throughout the whole or overall fabric of the city. Another